Big double header games today. We are going to talk all about them here at Time Out with Sports Anda. Arun, the tournament is showing us different colors. Favorites are being challenged. There have been low scoring totals. There have been wonderful chases. So this is the beauty of our international tournament, isn't it?
It is. I was about to say this is like, in the festival, it's time of festivals now in the calendar. And look at what we have midweek. We've got a double header and big teams playing today, Akhil.
Big teams playing today, the defending champions playing today, after what's been a very disappointing start to the tournament for them. So that is something that that everybody will be looking forward to.
Yes, the West Indies had a disastrous start to their title defense, but that's later in the day. Before that, we've got Pakistan v New Zealand, and Pakistan are riding high, Akhil.
Riding high, and this is the match that they'll be most looking forward to from what has happened, transpired before the tournament started. So not just the players, but the entire country will be watching them today and hoping and cheering them on. So this is a proper match.
This is a proper match for more reasons. I mean, you spoke about what's happened in the recent past, New Zealand kind of abandoning that T20 series in Pakistan in the last minute, giving Pakistan absolutely no preparation heading into the competition. That's one reason. But the other reason is if you look at the group, Akhil, if you look at this particular group, I mean, there's the group of death, obviously, which is group one. But in group two, India, New Zealand, and Pakistan are the three most fancy teams, right? Now, this contest between New Zealand and Pakistan is one of those which will decide which of those two teams will go forward. I mean, among India, New Zealand, and Pakistan, you'd fancy one, two of those three to go forward, right? Go ahead to the semifinals. So this is one of those contests which will determine who has that edge. Pakistan obviously now have the edge after having defeated India the other day. But now, if Pakistan are able to get the better of New Zealand in this game, they've virtually got their noses ahead of one step in the door. And then it'll come down to India, New Zealand, Afghanistan. Man, this game's going to be so crucial.
Very good point that because the rest of the three matches we are saying that those are the opponents that these three teams might be able to just win games.
Will
So I
fancy
mean,
to defeat those three teams, correct?
definitely. So you're right. This is a very, very crucial game. And for New Zealand, they'll be really, really up against it. In my opinion, Arun, because this is the first game for them. After a while, the players have not yet played together. And now to come up against a team which is going to be really high on confidence, everything suddenly fired for them in the first game. So knowing Pakistan, we know they are a very confidence-oriented team, isn't it? When the going is well, they all pump each other and they play together as a unit. That's when they are the most dangerous team.
Also, I saw these visuals on social media, Akhil, of the Pakistan dressing room after that win against India. It was good to see that, Babar Azam addressing the team and saying, let's not lose our concentration. Let's not fly because we've beaten India. Let's stay grounded. The eventual goal is to win the World Cup. I mean, let's celebrate. Let's relish this win. So that was good to see. And you're right. They've consciously made the attempt to stay focused. He said in the past, Pakistan have been riding high one day and they've crash landed the next day. So he kind of drew attention to that and he said, this is the team that should change that culture. So it was good to see that. They will ride high, but they will stay focused on the job in hand. They're also going to be favorites, Akhil. They're playing in the UAE where they've won last 12 games and look at what New Zealand have done in the UAE. These are numbers that New Zealand will not want to see. You spoke about them coming together, the odds being against them, but also the fact that they're playing here in the UAE. That's a disastrous and dismal record, Akhil.
Interesting. And lot of these games also around, I don't remember them playing a lot of matches here in the recent past also. So it's going to be very tricky for them to just come up against. It's going to be interesting to watch them. And knowing New Zealand, Arun, they actually enjoy situations where they've been thrust into in difficult situations in the recent past. Even the World Test Championship, we saw it wasn't so easy for them. but they managed to find ways to come back and win or compete well in those matches. So that's why I'm really looking forward to this game also.
They are big tournament players, Akhil. Consistently, they keep performing in the big events. You're right. But odds slightly against them because of the fact that they're playing for the first time in a while and the fact that it's the UAE where they haven't really done well. The last time these two teams met in the UAE in 2018, I think it was, Pakistan thrashed them 3-0. So the odds definitely against them. But a few good players to watch today. I'll start with the Pakistan openers. How good were they? They are in the form of their lives, Akhil. Look at the most top run getters in T20Is this year. The two of them are right on top.
They've shown that over a consistent period of time that they can win games of their own bat, Arun. What these numbers don't say that they are so crucial to the Pakistan team is when they score runs, their team usually goes on to win games. So, absolutely stunning numbers these.
You get blown away just looking at the quantum of runs, the average and the strike rate. But look at that last column, Akhil. 15 50s for Mohammad Rizwan out of 34 innings. That's nearly every second innings, just over every second innings, or just under every second, just over every second inning. And look at Babar Azam, 16 and 32. So every second innings, literally. Every alternate innings, he's getting a 50.
Amazing. I mean, this will be interesting against how they go up against the New Zealand quick bowlers also, isn't it? We are hoping we saw one of the left-arm seamers from Pakistan showing his magic. And there is another magician in the New Zealand team who can come and show some real skills with the ball. So, him bowling against the Pakistan openers is going to be fun to watch.
It's not a matchup, but you're right. You know, Shaheen Shah Afridi against Trent Bolt is one kind of matchup we're looking forward to. But Trent Bolt against the Pakistan openers is the contest you want to see. The ball's just swinging just a little bit, Akhil. It didn't happen in the Indian T20 League, but in the World Cup, there's just a little bit. And if that's available for Trent Bolt today, you can expect him to do what Shaheen Afridi did the other day. The two left-arm quicks, their records in the UAE, in Asia, in fact, is fairly good. I mean, you don't expect this from a Trent Bolt, do you? 5 matches, 10 wickets, average of 14 and a strike rate of 10.
Wow.
I mean, I know it's a small sample size, but still tells you that if there's something available in the ball in the air, he'll extract that.
You're right, Arun. This is a small sample size, but we have still not added the numbers from the Indian T20 League. And if you remember the final of the Indian T20 League the last year when he played for Mumbai, he was phenomenal. And he created the same kind of impact that Shaheen Afridi did the day before. So, both of them have shown that they can bowl very well in conditions which are not so great for medium pacers. Just a little bit of swing that you said, and it's fun to watch. So, that is the contest that I'm really, really looking forward to.
Watch out. If Trent Bolt can get one of those two, can dislodge one of those two, New Zealand have that small opening that they so desperately need.
Very true. Also the New Zealand batting, Arun. While we have not seen too much of them, simply because of broadcast, we don't get to watch enough games from New Zealand. But they've put together a string of interesting batsmen, T20 batsmen. If you see the names which are there, we've not seen too much of Devon Conway in T20 cricket yet. We've not seen Glenn Phillips bat too much. We've not seen Seaford bat too much against the Indian team. So, those are 3-4 interesting names who've chopped up a lot of runs at good strike rates, which is very crucial in T20 cricket.
Absolutely right. You don't leave out my favorite, Kane Williamson's there. So, Kane Williamson's will hold the innings together. But you're right. You know, a lot of our perceptions is blinded or influenced by what we've seen or what we've read recently. And most recent is, you know, what happened in Bangladesh. But remember, that side is completely different. You know, a lot of these players were not there. New Zealand come into this World Cup with a very different looking side. And you're right, some of the names you mentioned, Akhil. We didn't draw attention to that. But when we looked at the list of most runs, I think, in T20s,
Glenn
it was Glenn Phillips there at number 3, right? So you're right. Some of those players are in form and striking it big. The challenge is for them to adapt to what's on the surface today.
Yes, and I, before we move on to the next game, I just wanted to remind you about one game that New Zealand has stuck into my memory for a while, and for a lot of Indian cricket fans, is how they defended against India in the last T20 World Cup. Well, against a very good bowling lineup, a very good batting lineup, Ish Sodhi and Mitchell Santner showed that exactly spin can win it for New Zealand. So, and in these conditions, if they get the ball rolling again, those two spinners are very good in T20 cricket, Arun. They don't get to play a lot, but those are deadly spinners.
Yeah, correct. The spinners are good. They've got three spinners. They don't get under the spotlight most often, but they'll do their job. I was just looking at the economy rate, Akhil. It's fairly, you know, fairly standard. 6.48, 6.7, 6.8. So they don't go for runs. And, yeah, you know, if it's their day, they'll pick up their wickets.
Great. So these are the matchups that we are looking forward to in the Pakistan versus New Zealand match. Well, the defending champions, we mentioned them briefly once. They are also playing today. They've been rolled out for 55, around 55. And now things could only get better from here.
You hope so. I mean, I was at the ground working on that 55 match. And it was like, you know, they were finding the fielders. They were not finding gaps, which is what they're supposed to do in cricket. Every hit found the fielder. So I hope they've addressed that. You know, in these conditions in Dubai and Abu Dhabi, it's about more playing on along the ground. I hope, you know, they will do that tonight, hopefully. Or this afternoon, rather. Yeah.
Yeah, also, South Africa coming off a loss to Australia. They've not had the greatest start to the tournament. They are also struggling in their top order. They could not get off to starts. So they're again a side which is battling to see what is their best combination. One good part is they have an opener who's been doing really well for them, a left-handed opening wicket keeper. So Quinton de Kock has been the core for the T20 team, wide ball team, in fact, for a while, isn't it?
He's been in some form, Akhil, this year. And he's playing against his one of his favorite opponents. Form. I mean, didn't get too many runs in that game against Australia, yeah? But we'll give him the benefit of that. It's also because he's not played much. He missed out playing for Mumbai for a bulk of the tournament, didn't he? So, hasn't been striking it as well in the last couple of months. But if you look at it over the year, I think he's been in phenomenal form. And like I mentioned, he loves playing against the West Indies. Quinton de Kock against the West Indies. Mark down a 50 against his name.
Well, that's like a 50-plus score every second game. So, every second game that de Kock is playing against them, he's scoring a 50. Do you think they'll start off with a spinner for Quinton de Kock?
If there's Roston Chase, then it makes sense to start with the spinner, but not with an Akhil Hussain. You know, get somebody who spins the ball into the left hander. I don't think so. So I think it'll be the conventional, Ravi Rampal taking the ball away, trying to get Quinton de Kock to drive. We will see. I mean, I don't know what the West Indies are thinking. They just didn't show up the other day. So I don't know if they want to reject their team. But I hope they don't do that.
One battle I'm really looking forward to also, Arun, here is Kagiso Rabada going up against the West Indies power hitters. Andre Russell and Kyron Pollard, who bat down the lower order. Rabada has been a game changer for South Africa. He's shown what he's capable of bowling in the Indian T20 League also. So, him going up against these power hitters is also going to be fun, isn't it?
Yes, you're right. You picked a good contest there. But I will add this disclaimer there. I will add this kind of, you know, note there saying Rabada hasn't... I mean, I was the one who mentioned during the Indian T20 League that throw the ball to Rabada, I'll pick you wickets. That hasn't happened in the second phase of the Indian second T20 half, League in the UAE. If you look at his numbers, Akhil, his strike rates have dropped. He's a wicket taker, no doubt. But if you look at Rabada's strike rate, overall T20 career, it's about 16-something. You talk about T20 internationals, it's 18-something. And then you talk about T20 matches in the UAE, it's about 25, I think. So while Rabada is a wicket taker, something's not clicked for him in this part of the world and in these last couple of months. So I hope he gets it right. I hope that'll make for a good contest if he can find his rhythm. You're right about, I mean, was there a Yorker he bought to Russell? Was it a couple of years ago?
Yes, in one of the last overs of a T20 game. So a sensational Yorker that, and him, both are big players for the team. So this is more, again, it's a battle of pride also, where you want to show that you're one up against one of the champions from the other teams. So that's why I've picked this battle, saying that I want to see, and knowing Rabada, he'll also bowl a lot in the end overs when Russell and Pollard will be expected to bat. So him and Norke bowling those overs and these two power hitters going up, oof, that's what international cricket, and that's what fun for us cricket fans is going to be.
It's going to be a mouth-watering contest. Also remember, there's a Norke, you mentioned his name there just once. He's been quick, Akhil. He's been quick right through the last couple of months, you know, in the Indian T20 league. And now in the World Cup, the other day, he bowled 150. You know, 150 on these kind of tracks, you know, difficult conditions.
Difficult to get away.
Superb.
Okay, fantastic. There's one more stat that we should quickly address. West Indies batting, getting all out for 55. They must have had some team meetings. They all have so many senior players there. They wouldn't panic much. They know that they can still hit their way out of a difficult situation. But
no hitting their way out of difficult situation. I think they've got to play it smartly though.
Yes, but with these kind of strike rates that they have, Arun, do you think they have that game or they have the mentality to now change and adapt and try a new kind of game? Do you think that they'll try something like that?
See, the difference between playing in India, Sri Lanka and here, I mean, I say India, Sri Lanka because that's where they won their World Cups, right? India, the boundaries are fairly small, but here the boundaries are huge, Akhil. So they've got to adapt. You know, West Indies are boundary hitters, naturally boundary hitters. They can't just, you know, have their game built around the fact that they'll pick boundaries frequently. Doesn't happen in these parts of the world. In Sharjah, maybe yes, but here you've got to play it smart. Look at their strike rates. I mean, 160, 170, a couple of them are 160, 170. You know, Lewis is 157. Pollard's 130, Andre Russell's 155. That's fair enough. But look at the middle order. Look at Lendl Simmons 122. This year it's dropped. Chris Gayle's 138. This year it's dropped to 116. Puran's 122. It's dropped to 119. Hetmyer's 117. It's dropped to 116. So, you know, these guys are just not firing. And they're just getting stuck because they're consuming lots of deliveries. They just can't be playing boundary, 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 and I'll play out my dot ball, I'll suck out dot delivery. No, that's not going to happen. Now, you need to keep ticking the strike over, which means you're at least 100, run a ball, or 120, and then the boundary will put you ahead. So that's the kind of approach these guys need to go into the field today with.
They need somebody like a Marlon Samuels, is basically what you're saying, right? He's shown batting in Sri Lanka, he's capable of scoring a match-winning 80 while batting first, taking them to a reasonable total. And he's shown that he's capable of guiding a chase and allowing the others to keep hitting sixes. So, a Roston Chase kind of batsman, maybe that they can get in, who can also bowl who can bowl off-spin. Maybe that is something that West Indies can look at. But brilliant contest coming up. And at Time Out with Sports Sadda, like as always, we are going to pick the teams that we think are going to win. So, your picks, Arun, for the games?
I'm going Pakistan again for today. I think Pakistan high on confidence. They know these conditions well. New Zealand will be a little rusty. So, Pakistan for me. South Africa will be West Indies. I'm still going South Africa.
Okay, Pakistan for me also today, because they'll be riding that confidence. And I'm going for West Indies. I really want West Indies to start the tournament, start showing the impact that they have. I love watching them bat, and I'm looking forward to seeing what they can bring to the game today. So those are the favorites from our end. Please write to us, tell us what you think, who are going to be the match winners, about the contest in the game, and we'd love to hear that and see what we can talk about in the next edition. Thank you so much for joining us again.